King Darius was the king of Persia a long time ago, and because Persia was so big, he needed help to lead his kingdom. So he picked three guys to help him lead. One of those men was Daniel. Daniel was really good at his job. Eventually, he did such a good job that King Darius put Daniel in charge of the whole kingdom. Now, this made the other two leaders really jealous and really mad. They wanted Daniel out of the way so that they could be important again. Now, in Daniel's time, it was normal for powerful people to be corrupt, to cheat those around them and look out only for themselves. But Daniel was different. The Bible says he was exceptional. He told the truth and stood up for what was right, even when it was dangerous for him. Daniel was a really good guy. So even though Daniel's enemies tried to catch him doing something wrong, they couldn't. But they could catch him doing something he did every single day. Every day, three times a day, Daniel opened his windows wide and prayed to God, no matter what. So Daniel's enemies had an idea. They went to King Darius and said,
"You know, no one should be praying to anyone but you. And if they do, they should be thrown in a den of lions."
"Now, give the order. Then it can't be changed."
And King Darius made the decree. Now, Daniel knew about this. He knew what would happen if he continued to pray to God instead of the king. So what did he do? He did what he always did. He went home, opened his windows, got on his knees, and prayed. But he didn't pray to Darius. He prayed to God. Of course, his enemies were watching for him to do this, and as soon as he did, they went to the king. Then they said,
King Darius, didn't you make an order that no one could pray to anyone but you? And if they did, they'd be thrown to the lions?"
"I did. It's a law. It can't be changed by anyone."
Then they said,
"Well, Daniel still prays to God three times a day."
King Darius was really upset. He didn't want to punish Daniel. They were friends. He didn't want to throw Daniel in a den of lions. He tried all day to find a way around it, but even the king couldn't rescue Daniel. A king's decision was final. It couldn't be changed. So Daniel was put in a den with the lions with a heavy stone sealing the entrance. And the king said,
"May your God, whom you serve so faithfully, rescue you."
Even King Darius wasn't able to change his decree, because even a powerful king like Darius wasn't all powerful. He was still a human king who could be tricked, and he was. Maybe this is why Daniel only wanted to pray to God. God can't be tricked or messed with or undermined. There is no limit to God's power. That's the God that Daniel wanted to worship, and that's the God we worship today. He hasn't changed. He's still good and holy and worth our worship. Now, because God is so good, even though Daniel spent a night with lions who could have torn him limb from limb, the Bible says that God shut the mouths of the lions. When the king came back in the morning, there wasn't a scratch on Daniel. Now, those other two guys who tried to get Daniel in trouble, they didn't do so well with the lions. The king ordered them to be arrested and thrown in with the lions, and before they even hit the bottom of the den, the lions attacked them, and the lions crushed all their bones. Yikes. After this, King Darius gave another order. Everyone should worship Daniel's God. He said,
"He sets people free and saves them. He does miraculous signs and wonders. He does them in the heavens and on the earth. He has saved Daniel from the power of the lions."
This wouldn't be the last time that someone who loved God took a punishment they didn't deserve and did it willingly. And it wouldn't be the last time that a heavy stone was taken away to reveal that someone who should have been dead was alive. And I can't wait for you to hear that story.